Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. Great to have your company. Well, earlier this year, Cyclone Pam caused devastation in Vanuatu, as well as affecting the neighbouring Solomon Islands and Tuvalu.
And 8 months on, just how are the people of Vanuatu coping? Crystal Vaega has this story.
Cyclone Pam was the most intense tropical cyclone in the Pacific this year. It's estimated to have affected up to 90% of buildings in Vanuatu. Water supplies were either compromised or destroyed, and many were left homeless. Governments across the world rallied to aid the people of Vanuatu, support which continues to service those left without homes or loved ones today.
We've been labelled as resilient people. We get up, we move on, like. As a church, life goes on, and it's part of the spiritual recovery.
Away from the bustle of Port Vila on the other side of E Whati, Jacqueline appears to be on a positive road to recovery.
After Pam, I think we rebuild our homes very quickly. And yeah, so sometimes when visitors came over, they're really surprised to see people in Vanuatu are still smiling. Even the cyclone came, and it's really, really powerful, and we're very frightened. Yeah, but after the cyclone, we recover very quickly.
While work on larger buildings continues, support is still available from the Disaster Management Office in Port Vila, where food, clothing, and clean water are on offer. Every day, families, in particular women and children, wait to receive help.
We are looking at long-term recovery. They've programmed it for 2 years.
In Vanuatu, most people live a subsistence lifestyle. Like elsewhere in the Pacific, their land is their livelihood. Kava, coconuts, coffee, bananas. To sell, to eat, to share, and to survive.
Well, I think the big impact now is on agriculture and even tourism. Tourism, we still have some resorts that are still closed, and that has been impacted not only on the resorts but on employment as well. People have lost jobs, but once those industries are up and running again, then probably things will become a little bit better.
Our crops in the garden, now they recover, but banana, yams, manioc, not yet.
With another El Nino summer expected, locals worry it will add to their problems. Cyclone Pam shredded trees, and the lack of shade means the little water that lands dries up quickly.
We're taking it seriously. We just went through one devastating cyclone, and the El Nino impact on those affected islands is something we're really worried about.
The aid for Pam is now merging with aid to combat the effects of El Nino.
Those people coming in requesting humanitarian assistance, so we're giving up a lot of non-food items, especially clothing and other stuff. So we've been processing them every week. The process here is that people come in and request. We prepare a release form for our record. This process has been happening since March and still going on.